Today I'll be unboxing the Lilo and Stitch FiGPiN Mini Mystery Pens. These were available to pre-order in late fall of 2023. I got mine in January from Pink a la Mode for $10 per box, and there's one pin in each box. This is a 10-pin collection, and the pin designs feature Lilo and Stitch and Angel eating ice cream cones and other sweet treats. But these are a little different than the normal Disney mystery pins. So while this is a 10-pin collection, you can only unbox 9 of them. What? So I'll explain. So all fig pins are numbered, and they're all broken up into 5 different levels of how rare they are. And this collection contains fig pins numbered Y101 to Y110. So Y101, 102, 103, and 104 are the common pins in this collection. 105 and 106 are the rares. 107 and 108 are the supers. 109 is the hyper, and 110 is the ultra. So the 9 that we can unbox here are Y101 through Y109. 110 is the ultra pin, and you can only get that from the FiGPiN app if you collect all of the commons, rares, and supers from this collection and claim them in the app. And then you'll have a chance to get the ultra pin. So you don't have to claim the hyper pin. You just need Y101 through Y108, and then you can get the hyper pin, or sorry, the ultra pin. So the 9 pins that we can get here are Stitch with a pineapple, Stitch drinking from a coconut, Angel eating an ice cream cone, and Stitch eating an ice cream cone. And those are the common pins in this collection. Then we have Lilo with sunglasses eating an ice cream cone, and Stitch with sunglasses eating an ice cream cone. And those are the rare pins. And then Stitch biting into the pineapple and Stitch eating a 5-scoop ice cream cone. Those are the supers. And then on the back, we have the hyper pin. And this one has Stitch with a drink, a piece of cake, and an ice cream cone. That is the hyper pin. And then the ultra pin that you can redeem later if you collect all these is the same design as the hyper, except it's all black and gold. So those are the 9 pins that we can unbox. So let's open them up, see what we get. So I have 8 boxes here to open up, which is 8 pins total. And these are a little different style box. We don't actually open up a cardboard flap and then take the pin out in a bag. These just have plastic wrap on the outside, and once you remove that, the pin is on a little tray, almost like a shadow box, and it slides out of the cardboard sleeve. So the plastic does have a little pull tab here, kind of like a pack of gum. And so my plan is to unwrap these as we go, but if I struggle too much with the plastic, I may just pause the video and then unwrap all the plastic, because it might be a better viewing experience. All right, so there's the little pull tab on the plastic, and we should be able to just slide this out. There we go. And so now it just slides out of the tray like this, and we can see we have Stitch eating an ice cream cone. So this is one of the common pins, yes. And yeah, so it's on like a little shadow box, and it is on a piece of cardboard inside this kind of plastic box, but it would look good just on a shelf like that. So that's pretty cool. So we have Stitch eating an ice cream cone. Looks like a single scoop with some chocolate on it and some sprinkles, and it has a red background. So put that one right there. So that is one of the common pins. So good chance we're going to see mostly common pins here. Kind of how it works. All right, let's see what's in pin 2. If I can get that out. Okay, pin 2, we'll slide it. And this one is Stitch holding a pineapple. So this is another one of the common ones. So we have Stitch and he's got a pineapple right there, and it has an orange background. So the like shadow box background is the same color. So it's still that purple background. So I have a feeling that's going to be the same for all the pins, but the background of the pins are different. Okay, so we got two of the common pins. Be nice to get a rare or a the hyper. Well, the hyper is really hard to get. This little pull tab here doesn't want to come off, but yeah, I ended up pulling off the rest of it. That will work. There we go. So pin three, we have, another stitch with the pineapple. So we have our first duplicate there. I want to get Stitch eating the pineapple. That's one of the super rare ones. So, and again, to get that ultra pin, you have to get the 101 through 108. So that's all the commons, the four commons, the two rares, and the two supers. So I only have 8 boxes here, so I already can't get that. So I cannot get the ultra pin yet. All right, pin four, we slide it out. Oh, it's looking the same. Oh, it is the same as the first one. So it's Stitch eating the single scoop ice cream cone with the chocolate. So we have a couple of doubles there. As I said, these are the common ones, so there's a good chance we're just gonna get a whole bunch of those. There are still two other common ones. There's Stitch eating or drinking out of the coconut and Angel eating an ice cream cone. So if we're gonna get commons, at least hopefully we get all four, right? All right, this one's being a problem. So we'll just cut that open there. All right, pin five. Slide this. Do I see something different? Ooh, that does look different, maybe. It is different. It is Stitch drinking from the coconut. So we have Stitch and he's holding a coconut and he's got a straw inside the coconut and it has a purple background. So that is the one of the other common pins. So the last common pin is Angel. So I wonder if we'll get that one and at least get all four commons, right? Pin six. Oh, it looks the same as that one. It is. It is another Stitch drinking out of a coconut. So we have two left. It would be nice to get a super or a rare. And then after this, I'll show a close-up of these and then I'll go into the app and I'll claim at least one of each one. So then add them to my FiGPiN collection in the app and find out the scores and all of that. So this one, ooh, it's looking the same again. Oh no, it's Angel. All right, so we have Angel eating a single scoop ice cream cone. Hers looks like she's got some, it might just be vanilla ice cream or something, but some chocolate chips on there or something with a blue background. So now we have all four of the common pins. So good chance this will be another one of those. Hey, if it's another Angel, then I'll at least have, you know, double sets of the common pins. So our last pin is, I'm seeing the edge. Ooh, I think this might be new. It is, awesome. This is the one with Stitch with the sunglasses eating the ice cream cone. So this I believe is a rare. So we got one rare pin, which is awesome. So yeah, so we got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 out of the 9 that we could unbox. So that's good. So we'll take a closer look at these and then I'll pull up the app and then we'll see what the FiGPiN scores are for each of these. So I just wanted to give you a close-up look at this box design. So we have the sleeve, just a little cardboard sleeve with the front and back. And then you have this plastic little shadow box type thing. It's the same material that the FiGPiN bases are made out of. And then you have the pin attached to a little cardboard box here. So it's pinned to, you can see it's got two pin posts back there and it's pinned to this little cardboard insert and it says, get the FiGPiN app, unlock the serial number and earn ultra exclusives. We'll be doing that very shortly. And so then it looks like you can just open this up. That up, and then we can undo these. These pinbacks are kind of interesting. It's not Mickey pinbacks, it's FiGPiN pinbacks. But I like how they have a little groove there. You can finally grab onto them. Some Disney pins, I can't grab onto them. So there we go. And then now we can free the pin, and we can see the actual FiGPiN. Really decent size too. I mean, for a so-called mini mystery pen, this is a really big mystery pen. I like it. Here is what the back looks like. I put a piece of paper over the serial number because I don't want anyone else to see my serial number, but it says FiGPiN Collect Awesome, and it is an official licensed Disney pen. And you have the serial number underneath that sticker that I'm going to go put into the app, and then this pin will become part of my collection. Right, I just unlocked the FiGPiN with Stitch and the pineapple, and we can see that it's worth 5 points for mystery, series one is 20 points, and its rarity is a common, which is 15, so the story score is 40. And then I'm gonna go ahead and claim it. It's gonna be claimed today. And I can go back to my collection, and we can see that I have all five of my pins claimed. I guess you'd say unlocked. So all five of these pins are claimed, and I went in and launched most of them. So this one I'll go ahead and launch. And this FiGPiN launched on January 28th. So I'm the 33rd to launch. So I was able to launch all the common pins. But if you go into the rare pin, and I click launch, the launch date is not set yet. And so the way I understood it is launch day is set 10 days after the first person claims the pin, but someone else said that it's the first 10 people to claim a pin, and then the launch day is 10 days after that. So since this is a rare pin, not as many people have it out there, and maybe some people haven't hit claim yet. So I'm basically waiting for its launch day. When launch day does come, then I'll find out which position I got. Like, am I the first to launch this, the seventh to launch it, 20th to launch it, and we'll figure that out. So I've got all my Stitch pins entered into my app, and I got a few of them boosted. So I think that's as far as I can go here with my FiGPiNs in the app today. If you are curious about what all these numbers mean and what the red numbers mean, what the blue numbers mean, I do have a video where I go through the app and I explain all these numbers. I enter in Olaf and R2-D2, so you can see the process of how to unlock a FiGPiN and claim them and all of that. So those were the Lilo and Stitch FiGPiN Mini Mystery Pins. Which one was your favorite out of these five? This was a close one for me. I kind of have two favorites here. I really do like the Stitch with sunglasses eating the ice cream cone. I just think it kind of brings out some of his personality there. And I also like the fact that it is a rare pin. So it's like, that's kind of cool. But I think my favorite here is actually Stitch holding the pineapple. Just a very simple design pin. You have Stitch, he's holding the pineapple, and it's got an orange background. Very simple, but that one's my favorite one. I love that one. So that is my favorite out of the five that I unboxed. Some of the other ones that I didn't unbox look pretty cool. So I am loving FiGPiNs. I, you know, have bought FiGPiNs in the past. I think I've shown one like 2 years ago on the channel, and I never knew about the app and about how you can add the FiGPiNs to your app and they're in your collection and you get to see all the different scores, the factory scores, the story scores, and all of that. So that is a lot of fun, because once you are done unboxing your FiGPiN, then you get to go and almost have like a second little game that you can go do, and maybe it's even more rare on some of the scores that you get. So that's pretty cool. And I really like these the mini mystery ones, because they are still really good size. And these are big pins. They're kind of the size of the, like, the Daring Dragons. They might even be a little bit bigger than the Daring Dragons. So very nice pins. And I like the little shadow boxes they're in. You can almost just set those on a shelf or on a bookshelf or something. So very cool. So we got 5 out of the 9, I'll say. I know there's 10, but you can only get unbox 9. So we are still missing the Lilo rare, and we're missing the 2 supers, which is Stitch biting into that pineapple, and Stitch with the 5 scoop ice cream cone. And then we're missing the hyper one that's on the back of the box, which is him with the drink and the piece of cake and the ice cream. So those are ones I didn't unbox. So for me to get the Ultra Pin, I would need to collect 3 of those, right? 5, 6, 7, 8. Yeah, 3 of those. 10 whatever through 108. You don't need to collect the hyper. So I just need 3 more and then I can get the Ultra, which is pretty cool. But yeah, loving the fig pins. I do have some Minecraft mystery ones too. I know that's not Disney related, but I love Minecraft too. And fig pins, yay! More to put in my collection. Anyway, thanks for watching and I'll see you in my next video.